Ladies and gentlemen, I am so excited. We are just minutes away from what should be a very bittersweet evening, the WWE Network special, The Shield's final chapter. Joining me now to reminisce about their over 6 years of dominance in WWE, the Universal Champion, Seth Rollins, Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose, The Shield. Gentlemen, thanks for taking a few minutes here today. And first off, for you, Seth, it has to be bittersweet because not only is it your final ride with your brothers, but you're in your hometown.
Yeah, it is definitely bittersweet. Started off awesome. Woke up in my own bed here, you know, had my own coffee, worked out my own gym, but we're going to end the night, you know, saying goodbye to one of my best friends. So it's certainly bittersweet for me, but I think more sweet than bitter.
Have you guys,
the king of Iowa, man.
Have you guys gotten to the coffee shop?
Yeah, we just left there, actually.
So what do you think? Give me your fair assessment.
Excellent. 10 out of 10.
He's doing well. He's doing well outside the ropes. So.
Had a super monkey.
He has coffee protein shakes. What was that? Cortada.
Cortado. I'm teaching him, learning
what's
him up.
It? What was that to do the palate?
The sparkling water.
Sparkling water there.
Cleanse the palate.
They gave it to me. I was like, what do I do?
Yeah.
Deep in the coffee game.
Hey, let's talk about The Shield. Survivor Series 2012, of the debut of you guys. Did you ever think that The Shield was going to become one of the greatest factions in the history of all of sports entertainment?
Yeah.
I think we had a whole bunch of stuff on our minds, but I think that's what made us so great is we didn't jump ahead of ourselves. We broke it down and we had a bunch of little goals to accomplish, and then it built to the bigger, you know, the bigger stuff. But I don't know if I know I wasn't thinking. I was just trying to make that night work. I was just trying not to mess up that night. Me personally, that's what
I think we never put a ceiling on what we could accomplish or what we could be when we first stepped in here. It was a different environment, a different locker room, a different company than it is now. Yeah. And opportunities were harder to come by for three guys sitting down there in Tampa. When we walked into those doors, our chances of success were a lot slimmer than they might be for somebody right now. So when we walked through the curtain for the first time in WWE, when we came out of Survivor Series, failure was not an option.
That's for sure.
And we would have gone to any lengths. Oh, we had our, I wouldn't say we had egos, but I mean, if you want to call it that, we were ready to.
Maybe a smidge. Chip on our shoulder. Yeah. Chip on our shoulder.
Chip on our shoulder. We watched these guys on Monday Night Raw on TV while we were sitting down there in the warehouse in Tampa, and we're like, screw those guys. We're going to come in there. We're going to be better than them. And then they put all these super teams against us, and we found our teamwork, we gelled, and, you know, we relied on each other. I would have fought anybody in the locker room at a moment's notice to defend Seth or to defend Roman.
Almost did.
Yeah.
But why did this work? Why did the three of you work?
You know, the thing is, we had never teamed together before that first night, you know? When we came together as The Shield, we were all individuals, you know? But we all had the same mentality going in. We all had this idea that no matter what, we were going to be the best. And we knew that we had to rely on each other, working together to kind of like those hurdles that Ambrose had mentioned there, because the locker room was just a different place back then. So to get over those hurdles, we knew we were going to have to rely on each other, and that no matter what, we could trust each other inside the ring, backstage, on the road, wherever. And so I think having that same mindset and that same work ethic of just always wanting to be the best no matter what really is what bonded us, especially in the beginning before we really got to know each other.
But Roman, you guys are completely three totally different people.
I think that's what helps it work too.
Yeah.
Not gonna step on each other's toes. And we don't have two guitarists, you know? We got a bass player, singer, and a drum player, you know?
We're all trying to get to the same place.
I don't know
place,
which is which.
You know? We're all trying to get to that same
I
place.
Can't hit a high pitch.
The same top of the mountain. But I think we're all willing to take different routes necessarily, you know, because we all had a different skill set. But when you put us together, we just made our own highway. You know, it wasn't just about taking these crazy paths to get there. We made a, you know, a Shield highway to the top, and we kept it.
So Dean just said something that is of interest to me. He talked about you guys being almost like a band.
Yeah.
And he had mentioned bass player, drummer, guitarist, right? But he didn't mention the lead singer. Who was the lead singer? Who was the boss of the Shield?
Did I not say singer? I don't know if I could be the singer because I have to stay in low tones.
But I guess the point I was making was, who was the boss of the Shield? Who was in charge of this group?
I think we stepped up. We all stepped up in different times. And I think, and this is just coming from my personal opinion, and that's what's great about the Shield, is we all have very distinct opinions and we voice them. But I would say he was like the voice early on. He did a lot of the talking for us early on. But, you know, I think throughout the process and the evolution of this group, we've all kind of taken that lead singing role here and there. But I think that's what makes us special, is even though we are individual superstars, nobody passes the ball around like us. Nobody can take the ball and run with it like us, but we can also, you know, we can dump it off and let him run. We're unselfish like that. There's no other group like that.
Yeah, it's like a super team that work together on every level, where there's nobody who needs to be the star, you know. Like, if you look at it from like a modern sports kind of, you know, you were the Golden State Warriors, right? Because anybody on any night can be the lead man to drop 50, you know. We don't need a LeBron James or a Michael Jordan to run the ship. Like, it works best when we're all just playing off of each other. So it's we are the voice. Like, there was never a straight guy who was the leader. It was just whenever the situation fit, we work together and
pass the mic.
Yeah,
pass
the mic. True three-headed dog. The Shield itself is its own living, breathing, three-headed dog character.
But I have to laugh, though, when you said that. And the reason being is this. It seemed like over the years, as the Shield grew older, egos did start to come into play. And I look back at you, Seth, what you did when you splintered the group for the very first time to join Triple H and Stephanie.
You calling us old?
I think you did. You might have called us old.
Now, you have to admit that, come on, did your ego get away from you at that point in time?
Oh, maybe. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I saw an opportunity and took it. It broke my heart. I mean, it really did. But I mean, if you're going to go all in, I guess, right? You know, I can't just dip my toe in the water. If I'm going to dive, just go all the way in. Sure made some enemies for a couple of years, though. I don't know. Half the fan base still hasn't forgiven me for that one, man.
That's the Shield attitude, though. Well, yeah. Go for it. Screw them all, you know?
Oof. You guys have gone on to unbelievable individual success. So start with Dean. I mean, winning the Money in the Bank contract, cashing in, becoming WWE champion, Roman, four-time champ, Seth now three times, right? Universal champ. At any point, did jealousy start to creep in among you three when perhaps, Dean, maybe you saw Roman getting to greater heights, or Seth, you saw Roman getting to greater heights? Did jealousy ever creep into this relationship, even when you guys weren't the quote-unquote Shield?
No, because for one, they're my friends. For two, we're the guys who were, even if we were standing on opposite sides of the ring from each other, we're still the Shield. We're still gonna carry the load, drive the ship, be the workhorses. No matter what the situation is, it's just we keep the same attitude.
We're one of the only teams that can drop 150. We can all drop 50 all in the same night. I think that's what makes us work is, you know, this is it's a different business model. That we, our content, we have a network, our business deals, you know, our television deals. You need a strong team, and that's what you have in the three of us. And it's like three pillars. We're all holding up this giant, you know, company in this business. And I think that's kind of, you know, and you said it a long time ago, iron sharpens iron.
Yeah.
That's what this is all about. We're all ballers here.
That's where I was going with it too. It's like, I don't think there was any jealousy or any resentment, because anytime, you know, I would see these guys getting success on a singles platform, it wasn't about like, I want that for myself. Like, they worked their butts off to get to that point, so they deserved it. And it would just make me want to work my ass off harder to get to that point, you know? So it is a total iron sharpens iron situation, where it was like, oh, he's doing that, that's awesome for him, but man, if I want to keep up, I better hustle, you know? So it was never like, oh, he's getting something that I deserve or anything like that. It was just like always happy, always hoping for the best, and just wanting to be on that, you know, match each other's level.
It's like pure motivation for me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's like, so when I, you know, growing up with my cousins, the Usos, when I'd see them do something, I can do that too. You know, when I see y'all do something and vice versa, I think we see each other do something and we're like, I can do that too. I can achieve that as well. So we just feed off each other and it helps us climb even higher.
But see, Seth do 50 push-ups. I say, I'll do 51s, man.
Total one-upers.
Yeah.
So I've got a couple more questions as we celebrate the Shield tonight. The first one would be for you first, Seth, biggest Shield moment.
Oh, biggest one? Oh, man. Man, that's really tough.
I know there's been so many.
There's been so many, man. We've had such an incredible 6.5 years just filled with moments, like narrow it down to one. I'm still really partial to our first match at Barclays with Hell No and Ryback. That one just really hits because, I mean, everything was on the line. For me, like if we went out there and dropped the bomb, like not only was the audience gonna lose faith in us, but you know, backstage we just would not be where we are if we went out there and laid an egg on that one. And so the electricity in the crowd and just feeling the energy and everything come together at once, that one's still really special for me, I think.
Roman?
Since he took that one. There's so many, like he said, but I think I kind of have two that are sticking out in this moment. You ask me this tomorrow, it'll probably change. The double shot, when we started in Wales, jumped on the chopper with Fandango and some array, weirdly, and then did the Raw six-man and just going in there.
With Taker on the other side.
Going in there pretty much Raw on Raw, like with it just being crazy and last minute and going out there and getting it done with, you know, two of the greatest legends in the business. That was something I think we can all hang our hats on. And then when we all held the WWE Championship in one night, when you cashed in, it was Money in the Bank, I believe.
Yep.
You fell for the old music trick. Works every time, baby.
Works every time.
I didn't know, you know, I was blindsided.
And the fact that we all held the title in one night, I think that, That's pretty special.
Gotta watch your sticks, babe.
What about you, D?
The first one for me is, will always be my favorite. Just the raw electricity, the raw emotion. The stakes were so high. That was as close to, and three superstars against three nobodies. Nobody knew anything about us. That was what made a lot of those early Shield matches good. Was these super teams. You know, Sheamus, Big Show, Randy Orton, Cena, whoever it was. They tried different combinations of super teams and nobody could beat us. Nobody could figure it out. That one will always be my favorite. But to bookend it with what was our last match, then turned out to not be our last match. So tonight might be our last match. I don't book this stuff. So don't ask me. But in Cleveland, you know, to do kind of the greatest hits and just have the real emotion from the crowd, and that we've been a part of their lives and vice versa, them watching us on TV and following our careers from the get-go over the last 6 years or so. It was just a special moment.
Mine was the night you guys returned last year. And I want to personally, I got a couple of final questions I want to ask, but I do want to say personally, you guys, thank you for letting me be a fan again, because, you know, been around a long time, seen a lot of things, but you know, you three guys really made me a fan again of this business, and I say that honest to God truth on this day.
Well, thank you.
So I hope you guys enjoy tonight. I do want to end on this. You mentioned pillars, and as we head now toward a very historic moment in time in this company's history, in the fall, our Universal Champion on Monday Night Raw is Seth Rollins. The cornerstone now of SmackDown Live is Roman Reigns.
Let me stop you right there, because I already know what your final question is going to be, okay? And I don't appreciate people putting words in my mouth, and I don't appreciate people trying to tell the story of my life to fit their narrative, okay? 8 years ago, I walked into this casino. Now I'm cashing in my chips, and I'm walking away from the table. I won the game. And what I do with the rest of my life from here on out is my business. I answer to no one. This time the $1 million man didn't get what he wanted, because I can't be bought. So if you excuse us, it's time for us to go do the thing that I want the Shield to be remembered for, that's kicking serious ass.
WWE is live for a special event. Streaming only on WWE Network, see Dean Ambrose's farewell match as The Shield comes together for one last ride. And the cameras will be there for every legendary moment. The Shield's final chapter, live tonight, 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. Streaming only on WWE Network.